The videos that I do post that may be impressive.
The flag.
Most of the time, it looks a little bit more like.
Welcome to PricePlow.
Well, if you needed any other indicator that esports gaming supplements are the next craze in dietary supplements, this is probably your indicator here. Iovate, the owners of Muscletech, have just announced and released they're coming out with XP Sports, their newest line of supplements. It's going to be an esports gaming supplement line. I've had a unique opportunity ahead of time a couple of weeks back, and for the last couple of weeks, I guess, to try out some of their products and get a unique head start look at their supplement facts panels. They have already been posted by ourselves in Stack3D, so at this point it's no secret. However, I'm going to be able to give you an idea of what they feel like, because as you have probably noticed if you looked already, they're not completely transparent. Now, if you know me, you know off the bat that's already a bit of a negative feel. However, I'm going to give them an honest feedback here on what I felt from using the product. You guys wanted more proprietary blend reviews. I don't know why, but here they are. Start off this video, I'm going to say I don't have any type of business affiliate relationship with XP Sports. We do have some workings with some of the ingredient companies behind them. I do a little bit of consulting, a little bit of helping out, a little bit of content production. However, for this company, I have nothing going on. Just happened to get pre-beta samples. There are three products in this line. They have Boost, the powder, gummies, the gummies, and Zero Lag, which I took and I don't have any left of, the capsule product. I like how they did three different delivery systems here, because most gamers are probably not going to want to mix something up and drink it. That's more of like a bodybuilding thing, right? Gummies are easy to take, and pills are probably the easiest way to get it down. Each one is a unique different formula, packing a bunch of different trademarked licensed ingredients. I have the supplement facts panels up on my computer, because obviously I don't have a physical bottle to show you guys, so I will be reading off of the computer if you see my eyes darting. From the top, let's jump in and talk about powders. Now, XP Boost's powder is, like I said before, not completely transparent. There are a few ingredients dosed out for us. There are a few that are hidden. I am not the biggest fan of this. However, the ones that are shown give us a little bit of an idea of what we're in for. From the top, let's talk about, we've got New Level at 1.6 grams. That is the studied dose. Love New Level. I'm a huge fan of the ingredient. I was happy to see they started off with this. It's actually how I got linked up with the company, as I was working with Nutrition 21. They followed up with N-acetyl L-carnitine hydrochloride at 200 milligrams. Cool, sure. Neurosensory Matrix at 360 milligrams. We know none of the dosages in here, which this is the one that I really kind of want to know. You got choline bitartrate, which they don't tell us if it is VitaCholine, an L-isomer, or another version. L-theanine here, I kind of want to know how tired I'm going to be from the L-theanine. Got ginseng here, which does not give us the standardization, so I don't really know how efficacious this ingredient is going to be. And alpha-size at the bottom, which is the trademarked version of Alpha-GPC. Chemi-Nutra claims that it is the highest quality version because it is sourced from a natural source instead of being synthetic, free of carcinogens, all that stuff. Unfortunately, we don't know the dosage of this one either. In total, it's a 360 milligram matrix, so I'm feeling too good about this. Choline bitartrate and alpha size alone should be larger than that. So, don't know what to tell you guys. Honestly, this powder was mild at best. I wasn't the biggest fan of this one. This was probably the second favorite on the scale of the products that I took from them. It did give me something. It did help me out, but however, in the current environment of products out there, this was not as impressive as I would hope an esports supplement in 2020 would be. Finishing off, we got the Energy Focus Plus Complex, which is caffeine and hydrous at 200 milligrams. 200 milligrams is a happy spot for caffeine for me when I'm playing video games. I am not all that great at video games. However, the videos that I do post that may be impressive.
The flag.
Most of the time, it looks a little bit more like. So caffeine and hydrous, I don't want too much of because I get pretty hyped up and I don't want to be jumping out of my chair too much. So follow that up with NeuroFactor 100 milligrams. Love NeuroFactor. I actually get a great boost from that. This is probably what I was getting a lot of that benefit from. I said it was mildly beneficial. I'm attributing most of it to the New Level and NeuroFactor here. But looking at the entire formula, if these were all dosed out, I would expect a quite whopping response to this product. Last thing in here is the Shield compound. We have 255 milligrams total of watermelon juice powder, which is normally alongside citrulline to improve the benefits of citrulline, so I'm not sure why that's in here. Coconut water powder for hydration. Long time gaming, gotta make sure that you're staying hydrated. And lastly, we've got FluorGlow lutein. Now, this is a pretty cool ingredient here because it helps with, obviously, your eyesight and health. The problem with this being that something like lutein needs to be taken every day to be effective. So if you're buying a 30 serving bottle of this and you're taking it every day, that's great, that's awesome. But if you are skipping days on this, that's not going to be too great. Now, they do have in a few different of the products here, so that does help out with the frequency. But just keep that in mind if you're going to be taking XP Sports. You need to take the flora ingredient as often as possible. That's my second in the three most favorite, because it was beneficial, but it was not everything that I really wanted it to be, unfortunately. Next, I'm going to talk about Zero Lag. Zero Lag is my number one favorite. The pills in this, I felt a really good boost from. It is, again, not completely transparent, so I'm gonna be honest with how I felt about it. I really enjoyed these. They gave me a great boost. I had a great game on these. However, there is a little bit left to be desired. So let's start off from the top of this one. Again, we got 1.6 grams of new level. This is really probably where I get the most of my benefit from. I love new level. I take it on its own some days. I have samples from Nutrition 21 that I really enjoy. However, as part of an entire formula, I'm a huge fan of it, and hoping to see more of it this year. After that, we got choline bitartrate here. Choline bitartrate does not have a dose next to it. Again, I don't know if it is VitaCholine, if it's an L-isomer, if it's another version. I don't know the dosage of it. It's kind of depressing to me because choline is extremely important for acetylcholine levels in the body. Following that up, we got Serenade, which is a phosphatidylserine-enriched soy lecithin, a 200 milligrams supplying 100 milligrams of phosphatidylserine. This is a great ingredient for lowering cortisol, helps you stress less, might keep you a little bit more focused on the game because you are not as stressed and erratic. Like I said before, I get a little hype during video games, so this probably helped me out a decent amount here. What I like, though, is that they back that up with caffeine anhydrous and Zoom XR, two different versions of caffeine. Caffeine anhydrous being the fast one at 100 milligrams, and caffeine, the Zoom XR, sustained release caffeine at 50 milligrams. So you get a total of 150 milligrams here of caffeine. That's a fine amount for gaming. I do not want too much here. So while phosphatidylserine can be a little bit calming, you have the caffeine backing that up. Now, lastly here, again, we have Alpha Size, which is supposedly, from Chemunutra, the highest quality version of Alpha GPC. Unfortunately, we don't have the dosage here again. So, at total, this is a 2.21 gram matrix, and we are missing choline bitartrate as well as Alpha Size. So, the fact that it starts off with new level, and then it has 200 milligrams, 100 milligrams, and 50 milligrams, is telling me that there is about 200 milligrams left over. So unfortunately, I'm not feeling too great about the dosages of caffeine, bitartrate, and Alpha Size. It's just kind of the truth. I like the product, but just the truth here. Adaptogen Plus Blend, being the second blend in here, is a total of 205 milligrams. We have Sensoril Ashwagandha Extract at 125 milligrams. Now, Sensoril is a great ashwagandha extract. However, it's not as strong as, say, Shodan. So 125 milligrams is a really low dose. It's gonna help with your cortisol, just like the Serenade. It did before, but not really doing all that much here. It's nice they added it. Again, we have Flora Glow Lutein here. Again, like I said, if you're taking one of these every day, that's good because you need to be taking it every single day for the benefits. However, if you miss a day, that's not gonna be too helpful for the benefits that you're getting from this. We finish it off with Asian Ginseng Extract, which I'm happy that they at least have the 5% standardization listed. However, again, they don't have the full dosage here. Rhodiola Extract, we have no clue how many rosavens and seludrucides are in here. It's probably a 3% rosavens, 1% seludrucides if it's a standard. But again, no dosage here, so I can't really comment on that. And Huperzine A to help out with acetylcholine levels in your body by inhibiting acetylcholine esterase. I'm gonna be honest here, I really like these pills. They really made me feel great, but there's an absolute possibility it was totally like placebo on top of the new level. Got some good ingredients here. We got some probably underdose ingredients in here. It's an Iovate product. It's gonna be sold in big box stores, and it's definitely made for having an actual response, but also being profitable enough for them to put it at a high level and promote it really well. You're not gonna see the dosages that Ghost is gonna put in here or Advanced GG is gonna put in here. Unfortunately, this is a little bit more of a mainstream product, so this is to be expected. I don't see this as good or bad. It's somewhere in the middle, and hopefully you can get a good deal for it, because if it's not a competitive pricing, I probably would tell you to go for something more like Ghost Gamer at this point. Now, last here are the gummies. Gummies are the least favorite one out of this product lineup. I'm gonna be honest with you guys. I really don't see a ton of reasons to take this product. In fact, it's so mild that, you know, I'm gonna be taking a pre-workout in probably 2 hours, but I'm gonna pull this out right now and let you guys know what I thought the taste was like. I had it for the first time a couple weeks ago and I haven't had it since. They're orange gummies colored, but I don't think they were just straight orange. Definitely a little bit of orange in there. I could see maybe some other citruses in there. Tastes fine, doesn't taste bad, but my biggest problem with this one is that gummies are probably gonna be one of the most popular products for people to take out of this line because it's really easy to consume, tastes good and stuff like that. They didn't put New Level in it. For me, New Level was the biggest ingredient that's in this line. It's the most beneficial one for gaming, focus, decision making. We know that New Level is extremely helpful. And they didn't even put it in the one that's probably gonna be the most popular. So that's my biggest problem with it. Outside of that, start off with Serenade at 200 milligrams again. It's helpful, lowers your cortisol, keeps you calm. Alpha Size at 167 milligrams. Not really that great of a dose. 50 milligrams of theanine is gonna calm you down, but there's no caffeine to be counteracting with the theanine. Asian ginseng, standardized for 5%, and it's at 50 milligrams. Okay, it'll be a little stimulating. And Fluoroglow, 30 milligrams, good because it'll help with your eyesight, but being really honest with you guys, like this one just didn't have really much to it. The powder and the pills, I could see why people would like them. I could feel why people would like them, but the gummies didn't do anything for me physically, anecdotally. And when you look at the formula, this is the disappointing one. So after I took No Lag, guys, I'm being honest with you, I emailed Iovate straight up and said, hey, I really want a bottle of this because it's a little bit less than what Ghost Gamer gives me, but it's still really easy to take. I don't have to mix it up and drink it. And I had great results from it. The gummies, I would not purchase with my own money, just being honest with you. But the rest of the line, I can see why it might have a space in the category for most people, because hopefully it'll be a little bit more affordable than other gaming supplements. So this has just been a bit of a preview of the line for you guys. I don't have any affiliate relationship with these guys. I just wanted to put this out there because I didn't see any other real content on XB Sports. It is a little bit selfish. I wanted to be the first one out there with it. However, being honest with you guys with what I saw about it. The No Lag pills, I really enjoyed. They were light compared to other gaming supplements that I've taken. The powder was definitely lighter, and the gummies, I just really didn't feel all that much from it. I'm just trying to be honest on that one. So I hope you guys enjoyed it, appreciated the video. I'm gonna be moving a little bit more into gaming over the next couple months, I'm guessing, because I'm spending a lot of time playing video games and there's a lot of gaming supplements coming out there. So I hope that this has been informative and helpful for you. If you want to read the full blog post, there's probably a little bit less information on that one for once than this one, because that blog post, we didn't want to go too far in depth. Well, you can go over to blog.pricewell.com. For any questions on the product, I'd love to talk about it, so just leave them below. We can talk soon about it. Thanks guys so much for watching, and have a great day.
Welcome to PricePlow.